Good morning, children. I hope all you are fine. Today I am going to connect with you from grade 10, Sociology, Chapter 2, Labor. Labor, we know that we all need for any work, we require labors. But in the present time also the things is changing. It's not only those labors, they don't know the skills, they don't know the education. It's just in the present time, all the people know about the education, skilled, some more important things according to this. So when we start to study, then the first Plato, he wrote in his one book, the book name is The Republic. In that book, he wrote that human society is formed on natural inequalities. This natural inequality is based on division of labor. Because we are studying, there is a main topic of the division of labor. So why we are doing all this thing? Because the differentiates between the people, it is really not good for the society. But we are doing the according to labor equalities. So he wrote that all the human beings have different inequalities. So according to this, this division of labor is required. It means, example, if I'm giving the example, the food is produced by farmer, clothed by weavers, and the dresses are produced by tailors. So this is the requirement of the every single person labor condition. Okay, so those people are like food. The farmers, they are doing the food production, agriculture work. They really don't know what is the work of the weaver or what is the work of the tailor. So if they want any labor, they are just not going with the tailor and they are asking that if you want it, if you know the stitch, then I can hire you as my labor. They want to those people, they know the agriculture thing. So the same thing, if a people know the tailoring and the stitching work, that time the tailor will hire them, not the farmer. So this is the division of work, and that's why it is required, because according to this only in the market the people got their jobs. Like in the present time, if you saw that if any people, they don't know how to build a building or how to do a paint, do you think they got job in an architecture field? Or they got in any other field? If a person don't know the computer education or the basic computer, that person got a job in a data handling or in a data scientist. So this is a division of labor, because in the present time, according to situation, we need the categories which we are dividing. We need those categories. So, according to division of labor, Karl Marx says one line, division of labor create less skilled workers. In the present time, we saw that this world is a fully digital world. It is a digitized world. It is a specializing world. So, according to specialization, digital world, we need those type of people which we are required. Okay, what kind of this division of labor happen? I mean, what is the category? So they divide the labor. So there are, I'll just draw one diagram. If any labor is there, it means first they check their age. If the age is suitable or not. If a person was coming, their age is 50 years, can you assist as a labor?
No.
Because 50 year person don't have a capacity to just do a work. And suddenly maybe that person got ill, suddenly maybe that person needs some medicine, suddenly that person that can't work. So those age, according to age only, the labor category should be there. Because those are the youngsters, maybe the age of the 20, because we are not going for the below age, those are not required. Maybe 24 to 40 or maybe the 45, those people if they are doing the laborious work or if any technical work, they can go for the more age, but the, any, those are the physical work. So the people, those in the under in this age, they can do, but those are the below 20. they ask you that you know the computer, you know the basic language or maybe the English language, or you know the language which is required for the any company. Maybe some companies prefer the regional language, maybe some organizations they prefer the English, maybe some they prefer the Hindi, or maybe some they prefer the computer knowledge. So if you have a special skill, that means you got the job. If you don't have the labor, you can't go for that particular organization. Okay, then the next one is a taste. It means what kind of work you want to do. You want to go in an architecture field, you want to go in a other stitching field, you want to go in an other field. So there are more fields in the present time in the market. So which field you want to go, according to that only the people will choose you. If you are already just complete your education in according to arts and you just complete education according to be a teacher, but you want to go in an architecture field, it is not possible to do those work, right? I mean, you really don't know what we have to do, how to measure, how to calculate, how to build a room, what is the measurement of a room, what is the measurement of a kitchen, and what kind of color you have to provide to the customer. It is not your taste. If you are already set for your goal to be a teacher, you complete your education according to be a teacher, then how do you know the other skill which is really not there? Okay, so it's according to taste. Then the next one is a skill. It is a normal skill. Specialized skill is a different, it is a normal skill. It means for the normal job, if you are just going for the basic job category, it means you know first which area you are living, then everyone asking you what is your basic qualification. Because now in the present time, no one is giving you according to job, according to 10 plus people. At least you complete your degree courses, and after that your basic, at least computer education and the English and the regional language you should know. So this is your skill categories. Or maybe you are good in any other things that you have to go according to those. Some people, they are good in painting, so they can go for the art. They can be a teacher for art and craft, or maybe they go for the computers. So this is the skills. What are the skills you want to have? Then ability. Then what kind of ability you have to complete your work? If you're chosen for any work, then it is how kind of target you are set for your goals, and in how many days you have to achieve your goals. So this kind of ability everyone needs. Then the next is the talent. Okay, some people are just choosing labels according to talent. So if we are talking about talent, then maybe the acting, maybe dancing, maybe singing. So you know that those are the most famous singers, they need some playback singers. Those are the most famous dancers, they know they want some side dancers. So those kind of things they have to choose according to talent. Because this is a talent which you need an extra course for to improving talent, but the basic talent which is from the childhood you have to improve. Like maybe a person, a child want to really like singing, and he is every day practicing a day by day. And after when he got a first chance, then he just feel, okay, my challenge is this, that I have to improve this, and according to this field only I want to go for the next level. So this is your talent. According to talent, the labor is the region of labor is also there. Now the next one is the gender. According to gender category, it means male, female, there's also some work they are provided by male category, or some work they are provided by female category. So if we are giving you an example, for the most especially the teachers category, if you are coming, there are more females are there. So this is this kind of work they chosen by the genders, because they feel that they are more actively participate with the children. They just feel more comfortable with them. So this kind of professions, na, they are choosing this gender categories. Now the next one is the interest. Okay, what kind of interest do you have? Maybe you have interest in labor. According to this, the labors are categorized, and according to this, the people in the India or in the world, they are getting their jobs. Okay. So now we talk about the inequality in employment of labor. Okay. If already everything is there and we have a most of option to how we choose and how the labor decided, then why the inequality problem we are facing? And what are those inequality problems? It may be according to manual or intellectual labors. Those who are not, okay. Do you think in the present time everyone getting the same rights for the labors? No, because half of the time they are facing discrimination because of the color, because of the caste, because of the there may be skills and because of maybe gender. So because of all these problems, there are inequalities in labor and employment. In employment category, also we saw that there are more differences between maybe the salary, maybe the wages they are provided, maybe the work hours they are provided for the job, maybe the promotion categories, maybe the work portfolio. So these also are major inequalities are there, major problems are there for those people. So this is all are the something which is called, okay, if I giving you a short definition, then a result is available for a person either in cash or kind due to one's physical work, then it is called a labor. It means in Indian construct, labor has not remained a mere economic activity. It has become a part of a social structure and equality. And in India, labor is in a mixed with the gender, caste, reason and religion. So there are all the inequalities matter, and in the present time, according to Indian labor condition, their power and income is also rising. So it is all are the, I'm just repeating again, that all are the division of labor, which is what is the labor and all the definition, and how the division of labor are divided. How they have to divide it according to those all factors. Okay, this all affect, it's not considering more, but those are the major main points according to the division of the labors. Okay, so today I'm going to bind my session.